Shizuki Sagawa, on va pouvoir l'applaudir. Welcome, Fumod, on your director de la plateforme Planning Strategy, directeur du Global Software Center en charge de la stratégie cloud computing et du développement chez Fujitsu. Il a dirigé le premier projet de cloud en 2007, your first project in cloud, so stage.
Thank you very much. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Do you have a click? Yes. Do you know Astro Boy? Yes? It's a very popular Japanese animation of robotics. He is a hero. He is my hero. He is only 135 centimeters, but he is very kind, and he loves peace, but he is as powerful as Airbus A380. Today, you know, robotics become very popular. As you know, Google has acquired 8 robotic companies in the December of 2013. And there are many, many investments going on in Japan. You know, there are many ventures, universities, and the companies are investing a lot in robotics. So I bet you that in 10 years from today, we or each household will have one or two robotics at home. Do you agree? Yeah. Or you don't agree? So let me discuss with you why I believe the robotics is going to be popular in 10 years from today. And in order to tell you, can I go to the next slide? In order to tell you what's going to happen in the next 10 years, it's important for you to look back what had happened in the last decades and also what's going on today. Because I think the technology advancement or evolution is, after all, a consequence of a series of technology advancements or evolutions. If you look back maybe 20 years ago, we have Google. And Google, as we all know, has changed the landscape of advertisement business with their targeted advertisement. Now, Google is now $66 billion company with the profit of over $14 billion. But they have not changed only the advertisement business. Think about your smartphones or iPhones. How many of your applications are free? They are free because of the business model. They are getting the benefits from the advertisement, and they are giving all the applications or services free of charge to you. So this advertisement business model made the smartphone business more successful and accelerated the value of those devices. So there are implications. So it's important for us to look at the implications of each technology advancements. Salesforce.com, its pay-as-you-go model is now a standard business model for many of the cloud services. This allowed to accelerate innovations because the people can now start with small and can grow and pay as they grow. So they have a significant impact in the innovations. Think about Amazon. Amazon's Jeffrey Bezos instructed his employees to communicate only using APIs within the company. And so their internal systems have been equipped with APIs. They are all API enabled, which turned out that they could expose, they can externalize their internal systems to outside, which is the Amazon EC2. And as we all know that they provided you with the huge computing power, with the huge storage capacity, which again accelerated the innovation pace. Next. So we all we like to debate about Uber. Uber is very innovative company, but Uber wouldn't be here if there was no cloud, if there was no mobility, if there was no concept of crowdsourcing, which have been invented before. So if when you want to think about what's going to happen, it's important for you to look at what is happening in the past and implication of those. We are now in the third wave of artificial intelligence. The first phase was in 1960s, when machine learning became very popular. The second wave was in 1980s, when expert systems and neural nets became very popular. Now we are in the third wave. Thanks to the Mr. Hinton of Toronto University, he has invented new algorithm for the neural net, so now we have algorithm for deep learning. But the deep learning cannot exist without the huge computing power and the data which have been accumulated in the cloud. And because artificial intelligence is becoming real and can be used for business, there are many artificial intelligence services coming to available for us to use. For example, Google's predicts APIs gives you the power to do market analysis or spam comments detection services for your applications. IBM's Alchemy APIs have a capability of comprehending text or pictures, and you can embed those services into your services. Microsoft provides Azure Machine Learning, and their Project Oxford gives you the capability of face recognition. Now, proliferation of these AI-based services made a significant benefit to both users and the providers. The users, of course, can appreciate the power of artificial intelligence into their services, they can enrich their services, and the providers, in return, can get the data from the actual usage, and they can learn more from the actual usage of the artificial intelligence. So the loop between the user and provider, they make a loop, and which is the very strong ecosystem. GE, General Electric, realized that, and it's very important for a company to externalize their internal competence so that they can create the ecosystem between the users and the providers. So GE made Predix, which is IoT as a service. Their internal strength is the operation technology, and combined with the IT, they are now making the Predix available to public users. Next. So what's going to happen in the next 10 years? I bet there are going to be many, many enterprise companies who are going to externalize their internal competencies to access through web APIs or by means of web services, so that they can be a part of digital supply chain or digital economy. And those companies do not need to be big. In 20th century, when we said the success of the business is largely dependent upon mass production. So the theme in the 20th century is mass production. But in 21st century, it is mass individualization. So it's very different. You don't need to be big in order to be successful in the mass individualization. You need to be rather agile. You need to be specialized. You need to be part of the digital supply chain. So the competition landscape is going to be different. You need to move much quicker and specialize. For example, Fujitsu is working with hospitals and universities to develop a specialized treatment or medication for each individual person by analyzing DNAs or genes. And we are making those services available to the public, to the universities, to the government, to the hospitals. Very specialized solutions. And this mass individualization is going to take the cloud into the next stage. The mass internalization can be achieved not only through the software or cloud services, but this can be happening even in the physical devices, in the physical appliances. Using IoT manufacturing capability and 3D printing capability. And all of those technologies are now available to us. Our factory in Japan produces a PC, and we can make profits even for a 10 PCs specialized for use, because we have started to customize our manufacturing capability with IoT. And this trend is going to accelerate. So we can really tune the manufacturing capability to specialize use for each individual purposes. So all of these technologies are now available. That is why I believe robotics is going to be real. I bet you are going to have a robot with your nose, with your eyes, and they understand the faces of your family, faces of your friends, through the AIs. And it's going to be real. Next. Lastly, but not least, it is important to stress the importance of harmony between the digital and analog developments. When I say analog, I mean like legal systems, ethics, moral, human law, moral, maybe religion, liberal arts. Without the harmony between the digital and analog, the hero won't be hero. Hero could be destroyed. But I'm a believer in the human wisdom. Humans have invented fire. Fire is dangerous. But every time we invented a new technology, we overcome. We overcome so that we could lead us to the next stage and next stage. So with that, I hope that we, together with you, we make our dreams come true. Thank you very much.